In this video, I'm going to break down the 6 new features from NinjaTrader in 8.1.4, as well as the 10 most important bug fixes. Maybe we'll throw in a few more, we'll see. But this is what's going to save you the most time. It's going to simplify your workflow and give you a further edge. No fluff, just what you need to know and how to use it. So stick around, because this is the update you can't afford to miss. You know why I really like our subscriber base? Let me show you what you guys did to the last video. You really blew it up. So take a second to like and share this video. Thank you so much and happy holidays. In this video, we're going to break it down for you. First, we're going to kick things off with all those shiny new features from NinjaTrader 8.1.4 in that new release. What's new, how to use it, and why it matters sort of thing. Then we are going to dive into the fixes. These are going to be the most important that tackle those annoying little bugs and glitches that disrupt your trading workflow. So stick with us and let's get into it right now. Feature 15876. You're going to add the ability to hide or show all your drawing objects on a chart with a button or a hotkey. So quickly toggle the visibility of basically all your drawing objects on a chart. If you use our XABCD pattern suite, you can do that too with your drawing objects. So anything that you draw, you can hide or you can show just with the click of a button. So that's really neat. That's going to basically allow you to open up a chart and go to the drawing tools menu. And then at the bottom, you're going to see where it says hide all drawing objects, basically to hide them or to show them again. So click on the show drawing objects. And alternatively, you can assign a hotkey by navigating into the control center, tools, hotkeys, charts, and then you can hide all drawing objects. So definitely add that to your stream deck or one of your hotkeys that you remember, and it will be a very useful tool. Feature 47. Now, this is for your Schwab connection. What you need to do is first enable your multi-provider mode in order to use it. So you need to go into your control center, tools, options, general. Okay, you're gonna be enabling multi-provider mode. Then you can go into your connections menu, go down to configure, you can follow all these prompts and input your Schwab credentials and you'll be up and running. So fix 20136. Wait, a fix? We were talking about features. This is kind of a feature to me. It's listed as a fix because Coinbase once worked and it's now working again. It's been fixed. So as we were talking about the Schwab connection, I thought it would be important to talk about Coinbase. It is also now available for anyone that trades crypto. So you can log in. Anything that Coinbase has as a symbol, you'll be able to get in there. So if it's XRP you're looking for again, you can definitely put that in there too. And you can be able to pull that up inside NinjaTrader now by connecting to Coinbase. So they had an issue where, you know, connections were being dropped all the time, but this has now been fixed. So make sure you upgrade to 8.1.4 to take advantage of that. Feature 15145. You now have the ability to freeze your T&S on hover. So if you go into the time and sales window and you can open up that, you can actually freeze on hover by making it easier to examine all the data without it scrolling out of view. So you want to open up that window, just go to new and then time and sales in the control center, and then enable the hover freeze option by going to the properties, and then you'll see the enable freeze on hover. So when hovering your mouse over that window, the feed will essentially pause and then you can do your detailed review. So feature 17863 and 17864, this is going to be the customization of your size of your chart markers or your execution markers. So for example, for your chart markers, you can put a line or an arrow on your chart. You can right click on it, go to properties, and you can change the marker size setting for any of those 5 available options that you have. Just like you can do the same thing with your execution markers, you can basically open up the chart, go to your data series, and in the data series property, look for execution marker size and change that there. So you have your small, medium, large, etc. So a few different options to be changing those, especially if you are getting older and you have trouble seeing them. Could be one reason why you might want to make them a little bit bigger, or maybe you're just on a high resolution screen and you need those to be larger to see them. Totally understand. That's feature 17864 and 17863. So this one is really handy, feature 210. This is going to be to set nicknames or display names for accounts and adjust the simulation account balances directly from within the platform. So now you can open up your control center, go into your accounts tab, right click on your accounts and select edit. You can adjust the name or the display name for simulation accounts. You can modify the balances there and then just save your changes. So there were 98 bug fixes. You probably don't want to go through all those. So let me highlight the 10 ones you do need to know about. Fix 20091. This has to do with modifying orders after disconnection. So it actually resolved an issue where modifying stop or target orders and then disconnecting or reconnecting could result in order prices no longer updating. Obviously a big impact there. It is going to prevent a lot of order management errors that you might have seen. So enhance a lot of reliability in the platform with this update as well. Fix 12869 is a dropped connection recovery sort of fix. If a connection was to get dropped for whatever reason, maybe a network problem or a Wi-Fi issue, whatever it might be, it would not reconnect. That has since been fixed, which will help minimize downtime for you guys. And that's obviously a good thing. Fix 19306. So this is basically your strategy parameters not loading. It solved a scenario where strategy templates didn't load into save parameters. This has now been fixed. Obviously, this is going to improve things for you if you do use strategy settings and making sure that those are applied correctly. So obviously, a good thing. Fix 15887 has to do with the SuperDOM, the depth histogram specifically. This fixed an issue with how the depth histogram visualization was happening with the SuperDOM. Obviously, you know, it's a good thing to have those visual cues, so you want to make sure that that is resolved, which they've done in this build. Fix 19226. This has to do with the strategy analyzer and memory management. So probably more of a behind the scene thing, but for stability is important. It resolved a situation where memory usage was not clearing. So you get this memory buildup and it sucks up all your memory and things slow down. So obviously this will help keep things faster, especially preventing slowdowns or crashes whenever you're doing backtesting, basically improving the user experience. Fix 15948. This has to do with the strategy analyzer and addressing an incorrect order quantity during multiple objective optimization. Bit of a mouthful there. It ensures obviously accurate optimization results when you are testing your past strategies. Fix 14000 or 20315. This has to do with fixing trade performance errors. So this is basically going to fix errors when you had a disconnect when downloading the trade performance and that gave you incorrect results and display date issues and all this sort of thing. It has been fixed. So to ensure those seamless sort of performance reports, you want to make sure that you do get that fix in there for 8.1.4 to prevent any inaccuracies from happening. Fix 16517. So this will fix your account data filtering. So they resolved the situation where filter by account stopped working in a saved workspace after restarting. So a bit of a scenario, but it does improve your workspace reliability and usability, especially for traders managing multiple accounts. Fix 15876. This is going to fix your market depth aggregation. This is mainly in the SuperDOM. They've improved it so that it displays more accurate volume data. So this is going to provide you a clear picture of market activity, especially if you do scalping with the SuperDOM using volume. So that's a wrap on the key features and fixes in this NinjaTrader update. If you found this helpful, please make sure that you hit that subscribe button so you never miss out on future updates, tips, or tricks. And don't forget to like the video. It really does help the channel grow. And thank you for watching and happy trading.